In this video, we're going to work a couple of problems related to velocity, speed, and length of a curve. So the first problem is to find the length of a curve. We're given the curve r of t is natural log of t in the x direction, t squared over 2 in the y direction, root 2 t in the z direction, and we have to figure out the length of the curve. So the first thing we do is we have to figure out the velocity vector. The velocity vector is 1 over ti plus tj plus root 2k, or we can write it in the alternate notation as 1 over t square root of 2. So that's the velocity, and our speed is the length of the velocity. Whoops, this is r prime. And that's the square root of 1 over t squared plus 2, which is 1 over t plus t. And then our distance is the integral of speed dt. And so that's the integral from 1 to 4. Of t plus 1 over t dt. So we get t squared over 2 plus natural log of t evaluated at 1 and at 4. The t squared over 2 bit gives us 15 halves. The natural log of t gives us the natural log of 4, which is also 2 natural log of 2. And we're done. Okay, for our second work problem, we're going to take a curve, parameterized curve, and we want to figure out when is the speed a minimum? When is the particle going around this funny curvy curve going the slowest? So again, we have to figure out the velocity. Only now, the derivative of t squared is 2t. Derivative of 5t is 5. Derivative of t squared minus 16t is 2t minus 16. And we have to figure out our speed. And that's the square root of a big mess. 4t squared plus 25 plus 2t minus 16 squared. And when we expand that out, this gives us 4t squared plus 25. Let's see, plus 4t squared minus 64t plus 128, plus 256. And that gives us the square root of 8t squared minus 64t plus 281. Okay, it looks complicated, but figuring out its derivative is not so hard. We want to minimize this, so we want to say, when is this derivative equal to zero? So 0 is the derivative of the speed with respect to time. And that's, by the chain rule, that's 1 over twice that square root times the derivative of what's inside. And when is that 0? Well, that's 0. When t equals 4. So on the fourth second, the particle is going the slowest. And how slow is it actually going? Well, you just plug in t equals 4 into this expression. So at t equals 4, the speed is the square root of 8 times t squared is 128. Minus 256 plus 281 is a square root of 153. So that's the minimum speed, and it occurs at t equals 4.